Hello. Today we are going to discuss the topic of RSS in education and learn how to use the online newsreader called Feedly. First, what is RSS? RSS stands for Real Simple Syndication, or Rich Site Summary. Basically, any sites which are RSS enabled can be subscribed to by a newsreader or aggregator such as Feedly. After the Feedly user has subscribed to the RSS enabled sites, those sites will forward new information of interest to the user's Feedly account. Kind of like your own personal online newspaper, with only the sections of the newspaper you like. How does RSS work? Well, the old way of gathering information off the internet, the user would visit various websites, blogs, or news sites in order to get the information they wanted. But the new way with RSS, websites, blogs, and news sites can now send information directly to newsreaders such as Feedly, which will then compile all the information from those particular sites and forward them directly to the user, eliminating a bunch of irrelevant information. Why should you use RSS? Well, one, it saves time. In today's world, time is extremely valuable, especially if you're an educator. Wouldn't it be nice to have all your favorite blog and websites to just send their updated information to you? Think of the time that would save you so you could finally get around to grading all those writing assignments. New ideas. If you're subscribed to feeds from education sites, you can get new ideas from other teachers to integrate in your own classroom, making you a better teacher. RSS gears towards your interest. Gone are the days of sifting through sites like Yahoo or Google for items of interest. With RSS, you can now subscribe to those things of interest to you without all the irrelevant information in between. And last but not least, sharing. Not only can you gather from others, but you can share as well. For instance, you may have a class website. Why not enable it with an RSS feed and have your students subscribe to it? Now students will get to see updated information from it once you've shown them how to use a newsreader. Speaking of which, let's check out how to use the newsreader called Feedly. Okay, we're at the Feedly start page, and here you can see Get Started. This is for new users, or you can log in here if you're a current user of Feedly. We'll go ahead and hit Get Started for new users just to see what it looks like. And you see over here, once you hit Get Started, it prompts you over here on the left to start adding content based on different categories. And there's just pretty much anything that you want to type in. You'll find some article that you can, a website you can keep track of. Technology, you can see you click that, and there's all kinds of different things you could keep track of using Feedly. We'll go ahead and log into my account. And this is my Feedly homepage. And right here you can see a couple of articles have been updated for me to read. If you come over here, I've categorized different sections, education, music, news, etc. If I hit this on here, two more sources, you can see two other pages. I'm going to go ahead and hit these just so you can see what they look like. Free technology for teachers is one I'm keeping track of. It sends me different articles. And you can see here it says create flashcards from Google Spreadsheets. Could be a useful tool to use in the classroom. So that's definitely a one I'd want to keep track of. Another one, since I teach history, European history, I teach AP European history, and I've had a bunch of articles here from European history. That could definitely be a tool to use for me as an educator. And then History News Network, another history site that I can keep track of as well. And down here, a little more general stuff that I might use personally. Music, news, BBC, I've got Reuters, and then I have technology. There's a site there that I use to keep up with the latest technology. Now, something I'd like to show you to do is how to add content from an outside source. For example, I have my website here, The Guillotine Theory, and I've started a blog. Let's go to blog. If you scroll on down here, you see RSS feed. If you right-click on that and hit copy link location, then go back to Feedly and paste that into the search box and hit enter. And you can see my website came up, and I want to go ahead and add that. And I'll go ahead and add it under education category. And it should be added. We'll go back to my Feedly, and yes, it has. So you click on that, and now, just to make sure, my European blog has come up, and there's my post, so I know it's keeping track of it. So this could be a useful tool for students in the classroom, if you have a classroom website, to keep track of updates that are going on in your class, to homework assignments, different, whatever you want to post pretty much. And so you can see here how a tool like that could be useful in the classroom. So go ahead and I advise you to give Feedly a try. If nothing else, for you to keep track of your favorite sites, but try it in the classroom and try and get your students involved in it as well.